All right. So, last up for the the trifecta of FUD. Janet Yellen. So Janet Yellen, she was the head of the Federal Reserve from 2014 2018, I believe it was, or 2012 2016, one of those two. I was getting confused. But now she is the nominee for the Treasury. And she stood up during her commencement or during her hearing and said, hey, we need to really take a look at cryptocurrency because they're used for illicit activity. And when I read this, I'm like, okay, well, everybody else and their mother said the same thing, so whatever. But people were really flipping out about this, like, oh, no, because this person's going to bring everything down. She's not going to bring it down. So, again, we have to take a look at the details. The devil is always in the details. Isn't that how it works? So this was a follow-up article from CoinDesk, and they said Janet Yellen offers Senate a more nuanced take on crypto. And this is what was actually said. The Treasury Secretary nominee said that while cryptocurrencies can be used to finance terrorism and other illicit activities, that's what everybody talked about. She's going to shut it down because of all these illicit activities. They also have the potential to improve the efficiency of the financial system in a written response to the Senate Finance Committee. She quotes, or is quoted as saying, I think we need to look closely at how to encourage their use for legitimate activities while curtailing their use for malign and illegal activities. Great. So she wants to use it, but she doesn't want it to be used for legal activities. That seems pretty reasonable, I think, right? I mean, we have anti-money laundering and KYC because of the dollar, which is being used so prevalently for all these different illegal activities, like with the cartel and with terrorism, all the big bad things that are out there. So yes, that is what is used. Dollars aren't evil, but they're used by evil people. Bitcoin's not evil, but it's used by evil people. And of course, if you can regulate as little as you can, then that's good. Again, people always say, ah, Rob, you're so big on regulation. You should be not to be so much in regulation. Look, regulation's like cake. A slice of cake's okay, but the whole cake will kill you. So just remember that a little bit of regulation goes a long way. Now, hopefully, it'll be hands-off. And of course, you're welcome to say what you want in the comment section. I'm sure you'll have a lot of opinions. But I just think a little bit would go a long way. And of course, there's always a happy medium, just gotta find it. If confirmed, she states, I intend to work closely with the Federal Reserve Board and the other federal banking and securities regulators on how to implement an effective regulatory framework for these and other fintech innovations, which is great news. She wants to work with other people. Whether you agree with what she's actually gonna do or not is up to you. But I will just say this, and we talked about this today in the first video. See this guy right here? I was saying this guy gave a great presentation on blockchain, money. He talked about Bitcoin, Ripple, XRP, and everything else. Very knowledgeable guy. I was like, who's this guy? You know who that guy is? That's Gensler. And Gensler here, well, I was sorry, his first name, Gary Gensler, he is the pick to head the SEC. So at least, at the very minimum, this guy knows cryptocurrency digital assets quite well to give a presentation at MIT. So that's pretty good. I will take that guy. And on top of that, the OCC looks like they may tap a former Ripple board advisory member. Not a board member, but an advisory member to Ripple. And his name is Barr. I forget his first name, but yeah. Michael Barr. Michael Barr, former U.S. Treasury Department official and Ripple member. So great. So now we got two guys in there that know a lot about cryptocurrency digital assets, which could help, I believe, Janet here to distinguish about what really should be done. So hopefully it all work itself out through dialogue and a little compromise. But that is what is going on right now for the trifecta of FUD. So hopefully I explained it pretty well. But I will end up with this. There is a fourth dark horse, and I think this one is even more dangerous than the other three that we just talked about right now. This one is really bad. So let's break into it.